because patchouli oil in Aceh is the best patchouli in Indonesia, and therefore is the best patchouli in the world. Yeah, because it's a unique characteristic. The patchouli from Aceh has contained patchouli alcohol higher than other patchouli in Indonesia. So it can be reached until 32-34% of the patchouli alcohol content in patchouli oil of Aceh patchouli oil. If we look for data in Aceh, in this table we can see that among 23 district in Aceh, among 23 district in Aceh, we have 16 of 23 district in Aceh have a potential of patchouli. So almost all area in Aceh we have patchouli, and also patchouli in Aceh has a very very long story. This picture, I take from the Museum of Dutch in Netherlands, in Belanda, we got a lot of story about patchouli in Aceh. So we also found that the fact that patchouli in Indonesia we call Nilam, Nilam actually stand for Netherlands in this Lanbu Aceh Maskapits. This is the Dutch company which done trading, international trading for the patchouli. So in the past, they send the patchouli plant from Aceh to the Singapore and also Malaysia. At that time, Malaysia and Singapore still unity, in the name of Malaya. And we can see in this picture the car to transport the patchouli plant. This car has BL928. You know, if you find the information from the Indonesia history, you will find that the number of the car in Aceh, we use BL. So BL is come from the colonial era in Indonesia. So this is a very very long story of patchouli in Aceh. So why the patchouli is has a very good market in the world? Because of the chemical, organic chemical compound which contain in the patchouli plant. For example, we can find the patchoulol or patchouli alcohol, and also another compound like caryophyllen and also azulen and many others organic compound, chemical compound in the leaf of the patchouli. And this compound actually can be function as antivirus, and also antibacteria, antifungus, and also many other functions. So a lot of function of the chemical compound in the patchouli oil. That's why patchouli oil very very popular in the world, especially for the fragrance or perfume. So with patchouli alcohol, the perfume or the fragrance will be long lasting. So for example, if you spray the perfume like this, for example, this perfume produced by ARC, I spray this one to the body, it will stand only 2 hours, only 2 hours. But if we put patchouli inside, the smell will be 12 hours, will be 24 hours. And also if we spray to the shirt, actually it will be stand for five days. So that's why the industrial business in the world is really really need with the patchouli. So if we look for another information about patchouli in Aceh, we will find that in the past Aceh ever supplies 70% of world patchouli demand. So 70% of the world patchouli demand in the market, in the international market, is come from Aceh. Yeah, but now because of the regulation of the trading and also the managerial of the business, it's very decrease of the production of the patchouli in Aceh. We now only supply around 10 to 15% of the world patchouli demand. That is very low. But yeah, even the production of patchouli oil in the last few years lower in Aceh, but Aceh patchouli oil still has a good performing in the market because the unique characterization of the patchouli of Aceh. This certificate is come from Depkumham, yeah, Kementerian Hukum dan HAM or the Republic of Indonesia. This is something certificate like the patent, yeah, patent. But if patent has been give to the individual or the person, this certificate we call IG, yeah, indikasi geografis or geographic indication. It's a share. It's a gift to the community. So the patchouli of Aceh has a geographic indication or GI, yeah, geographic indication that is imply that the patchouli Aceh is very unique characteristic. Now, if we go around to Aceh in the mountain, yeah, in the village, everywhere we can find a lot of the ravenery, traditional ravenery unit of the patchouli, something like this, yeah. It's come from the used oil drum before. They clean it and they design as a ravenery unit. But the quality of the product from this ravenery unit is really low, yeah. So in 2016, I go around Aceh, yeah. I go to Aceh Besar, Aceh Jaya, West Aceh, and also South Aceh. I go to the middle of Aceh. I go everywhere. I meet the community, yeah. I meet the people. I meet the government, and also meet the NGOs, yeah. Non-government organization and many others. I try to find why the patchouli oil of Aceh is very good quality, but why the people still in poor? Yeah, well, the people is still in poor. So this is a drive, a very high driving force for our team to do something innovation. Yeah, to innovate the process of the patchouli because we need to help our people in Aceh. We need to increase the prosperity in Aceh as the farmer. So after I go around Aceh, I found that a lot of problem in the Aceh patchouli oil industry. Yeah, it's around 24 problems. It can be divided into four groups of the problem. The first problem we call as upstream of farm agro industry. Yeah, upstream of farm agro industry is talk about the seed, talk about nursery, we talk about the fertilizer, and we also talk about the pesticide. Yeah, pesticide, and the second group of the problem we call on farm problem. Yeah, in on farm problem we face the problem such as the about the land, yeah, about the planting methods, about the deforestation of the farming, yeah. So a lot of the problem. And the third group of the problem is we call downstream. In downstream problem, it's about the ripenery, about the machine for fractionation, about the derivative product, about the waste of the process, and also about energy, yeah. So a lot of problem also in the downstream group. And the fourth group is we call a supporting subsystem problem. It's about the market, about the regulation, about the research, about the financing, many others problem. So based on this problem, we then develop many concept, many document as like action plan for a system inovasi daerah, In Indonesia, we call system inovasi daerah, like the concept for innovation system of the district and province in Indonesia. We talk about the Pacholi here, or Nilam, We talk about Nilam. And also, we also write the other roadmap for Atsiri of Aceh. In this document, we talk about the Pacholi, we talk about the Nutmeg, or Pala, and also Citronella, and also clove, clove oil. And also we have a master plan for development of innovation cluster of Pacholi in Aceh Jaya district. And also we have a master plan and detailed engineering design for Pacholi industry in Aceh Jaya. So based on the problem, we then design what kind of the problem solving we can do with this roadmap and guideline. We then also develop the strategy of the development of Pacholi industry in Aceh. We know in Aceh, Aceh is one of the rich, the rich province in Indonesia. However, our community is still in poor. Aceh people are still in poor. The prosperity level in Indonesia for Aceh is the sixth poorest province in Indonesia. This is really, really make us sad. Why the rich country, but the people are still in poor. So actually, in the past, we have the biggest exploration of gas, natural gas, we have in Aceh. Maybe some of you have known about the Arun. Arun is one of the area in North Aceh that is explore natural gas. The highest innovation has been done there. A lot of oil and gas explore and used by the government and also by company to generate the income for the country. However, the people after 30 years, the innovation done in Aceh Utara, North Aceh, the people there still in poor. That we identify that the problem, one of the problem is because innovation that has been done there is not inclusive innovation, but exclusive innovation. So exclusive innovation, we change, become inclusive innovation. This is one of the fundamental strategy that we develop to our industrial process. And the second strategy is we need to develop roadmap and master plan that I have explained to you just now, And also the pentahelix approach. What mean the pentahelix approach, The pentahelix approach is a synergy among the government and also university and also a private sector business, And also community and media. So this problem is very, very huge problem for the community of Aceh. So really hard if we don't do collaboration with others. So we need collaboration with other stakeholders in Aceh. And then we develop the program. We develop the program. We talk to the farmer. We teach them how to plant the Pacholi. We develop the good practice, the good agriculture practice to the people in Aceh. And then also we try to find the partner. For university, we have ARC of Shahwala University and also others university in Indonesia. So we have friends around Indonesia, the university, we have the memorandum of agreement, memorandum of understanding with others university to help us. And from the government, we have BAPEDA, maybe you know BAPEDA. BAPEDA is the planning board of development of Indonesia. Yeah, in Jakarta, we call BAPENAS. Yeah, in province, we call BAPEDA. And also we have a government of Aceh Jaya here. We have a central bank, yeah, Bank Indonesia, and also BPPT. BPPT is stand for Badan Penelitian dan Penerapan Teknologi in Jakarta, and also others ministry, yeah, others ministry such as Ristek Dikti, yeah, Ristek Research and Technology Ministry, and also Education Ministry, and also Industrial and Data Ministry, and many others. We also have agreement with the community, yeah, representative by FNA. FNA is Forum Nilam Aceh, and also Nilam Aceh Heritage. So this is all our friend, and together, yeah, university, government, business, community, and media, we develop innovation for the industrial process in patchouli oil. Yeah, start from ideas until the advanced market. So we work together. We divide what we have to do together. Yeah. In 2018, yeah, we did collaboration with the Korea. Yeah, this is the Korea. We do collaboration and we sign the agreement with Korea to develop industrial process in Aceh. And then we develop our team. Yeah, our team. This is our team. This is come from many area of expertise. Yeah. From agriculture, from engineering, from legal process, and many others expertise from the lecturer, professor, a doctor from Syekh Kuala University. We joined together in ARC, and then we then work together for develop many program in patchouli industry in Aceh. This is our team in 2020. Yeah. And this is the master plan, start from upstream of farm agro industry until supporting subsystem that I have mentioned before. Yeah, we also organize the concept for stakeholders analysis. Yeah, what the government has to do, what a parliament has to do, what the business sector has to do, what the academician from university has to do, what NGOs has to do, and many others. So everything we have defined to work together to develop the industrial process in patchouli industry in Aceh. This is the pilot project in Aceh Jaya. Yeah, we have private sector here. Yeah, PT Haldin, PT General Aromatic, and also Koperasi Industri Nilam Aceh. We define the price of the patchouli 500,000 rupiah per kilogram. Yeah, this is the good price for the farmer. And also in our research center, we develop the roadmap until 2020. Yeah, in 2020, we hope our research center will be transformed to science and techno campus, yeah, center of excellence of patchouli oil. We also developed the research roadmap until 2022. Yeah, start from upstream of farm agro industry, on farm, downstream, and also supporting subsystem. So we develop what we have to do with the research project. Yeah, to increase the income generating and income revenue for patchouli process in Aceh. And also, this is very important, yeah, especially for our university and also for the student. Usually, yeah, we start the research start from TRL. Yeah, TRL is stand for technology readiness level. So before we send the product, our patchouli product to the market, yeah, before we send the patchouli product to the market, we need to fulfill the TRL level, TRL level until 9, yeah. Usually we go step by step until 9, and then after TRL reach 9, we send the product to the market. But in our research center, we don't wait until TRL 9, yeah. We start from TRL 1, 2, 3, 4, and then after we got 4, we directly send the product to the market, yeah. And then after that, we wait for the response from the market. What is the response from the market to our product? And then if the market responds something, then we go back to the back, yeah. We go to the TRL 8, 7, 6, and etc. So we jump, yeah, from TRL 4 to TRL to the market, and then we wait for the response, and then we revise the technology and something others. And then we also try to find the funding, yeah, from the government. We got the money from government 2017 until 18, and also 19 we got 3.5 billion. 2020 we got 2.2 billion, and also we got many machine from the government, yeah. And then we develop our project, yeah. We establish the greenhouse to nursery, yeah. We create the refinery unit with innovation process and others. We also develop the market, yeah. We develop the product, yeah. Usually the farmer only has the plant and also the raw oil of the patchouli. We develop the innovation here. We develop the product. Yeah, we develop the fragrance, high grade patchouli, soap, repellent, and others product. Yeah. Then we start from the upstream. We develop the nursery in Aceh Besar and also in Aceh Jaya. This is the in Aceh Jaya. And also we develop the tissue culture technology, yeah, to develop the seed of the patchouli. And also we establish Nino Park. Yeah. Nino Park stands for Nilam Innovation Park, yeah, where we can develop the research here. This is all in Nino Park, the nursery in Nino Park. And I will show you the short video when Nino Park launching by Pak Dirjen, ya. Okay, I try to another short video. Pesticide by Professor Rina, our research team. We develop organic fertilizer by Dr. Sabrudin. We use these two biopesticide and fertilizer for patchouli. We try to our land and we got the very good result. Yeah, and then this is the land for establish cluster innovation, and we also develop the planting with many stakeholders. Yeah, we work with the farmers, and this is one of our project with our friends in Gayo. Yeah, you know L'Oréal Paris. Yeah, L'Oréal Paris. They has been visit this land. Yeah, they have to walk 2 hours. Yeah, walk 2 hours to reach this area. And we developed the program with Central Bank of Bank Indonesia, Local Economic Development, yeah, in Aceh Jaya. we develop the process unit, refinery unit, the modern refinery unit to process the patchouli. And also we develop IoT. IoT stand for Internet of Things. So we develop fertigasi system, where we use sensor in the Nino Park. We use solar system. We use greenhouse, artificial rain. We develop everything here. And this is the traditional refinery unit of the farmer. It's produce a low quality of the patchouli. And then we innovate the refinery units. We can develop the patchouli, high grade patchouli. You can see here the quality of patchouli. The color is very good, and this is the export standard quality. Export standard quality. We can send directly this patchouli to the world. And then based on this machine, we develop also teaching industry for the student. So our student can learn directly from this refinery unit. They can learn the process in the industrial scale, not only in laboratory scale, but also industrial scale. And also with this machine, we develop two kind of the patchouli. One kind we call the light fraction of patchouli, and the second part of the we call heavy fraction of the patchouli. This contain lower patchouli alcohol, and this contain higher patchouli alcohol until 80% of patchouli alcohol. This product then we use for a perfume, perfume, and this product we use for others product like aromatherapy, body lotion, and then body lotion shop, hand sanitizer, and many others product. We has been tested in the laboratory with gas chromatography analysis. We can find that a patchouli alcohol content reached 79.4%. It's very good to use this patchouli to perform. Usually, if the patchouli alcohol reach 60%, we can use it as the fixative. Fixative, the natural compound that can catch together the smell. So the perfume will be long lasting if we put the patchouli oil which contain 60% of patchouli alcohol. So we can develop many type of the patchouli oil. We can develop 43%, we can develop 54% and until 80%. And also we can develop the crystal patchouli, 100% of the patchouli. With this compound, then we develop our product. We create the perfume. We create the perfume. This kind of perfume we call our perfume Nilam. I always use this perfume. This is produced by ARC. It's very, very good smell and also long lasting. So if I spray to my body, it will stand until 12 hours. 12 hours. And we only sell this one very cheap in Aceh, only 150,000 rupiah. If we send this to France, it will be cost around 1.5 million. 1.5 million. So, but maybe in the next time we will send this product actually to the West Asia, South Asia. Actually, we can't beat the perfume, a friend perfume. We can beat them because they are very advanced level. But we can choose some of the neighbor country from Aceh. We can send this perfume to our neighbor country. And actually, many people from from Malaysia, who has been come to Bandar Aceh, we give this one to them. And also we develop this one, medicated oil based on patchouli and eucalyptus. Not eucalyptus actually, but kajiput. Kajiput oil, it is really, really similar to eucalyptus. So our eucalyptus in ARC, usually natural eucalyptus, it can be contain 1.8 cineol. Yeah, cineol, it's around 45 until 52%. Yeah, usually natural eucalyptus kajiput oil of Aceh, it's contain 1.4 cineol of 45 until 52% of cineol. But with this machine, and also with this machine, we can produce the eucalyptus and come up with 85% of 1.8 cineol. You know cineol, yeah, it's very popular in the last few months, I think, in Indonesia because of COVID, because one of the big company in Indonesia, they exposed that cineol can be used as anti-COVID, yeah, anti-COVID. But actually, it really need to do further research about this, yeah. And then after we got this type of the product, we developed the launching of the product by a university leader. Yeah, we also train the student. Yeah, we have a lot of students. We train them. We give them some advice and maintain the connection with them. Yeah, and then we can develop many products. This is the perfume. This is hand sanitizer. This is the soap. This is aromatherapy. Yeah, we can use diffuser like your video just now. Yeah, we can use this one, and we can use this one as a hair tonic. And we also develop this one is scrub, body scrub. Yeah, this one is patchouli body scrub. We use also coffee in this product, and also many others product. Yeah, for example, this is bio lotion. This is a patchouli body salve and many others product. And also some of our product of Aceh Patchouli has been branding in Korea, yeah, with the brand of Hiloma. Yeah, well, we do collaboration with the Korea, and they brand our Aceh Patchouli oil with the name of Hiloma. And this is the students, yeah. I can't count anymore how much I have been meet and see and give some inspiration to the students. Yeah, it's more than 5 years already. Yeah, so actually this is our student we developed since our class. Yeah, actually I teach the student about the chemical industrial process in chemical engineering department of Syekh Fawaz University. You know, in the first meeting of the class, yeah, the first meeting of the class, we divide the class into 5 groups. Yeah, every group consists of 5 students, and every group should be develop the one product based on the patchouli or any other essential oil. And at the end of the semester, the student will be collect their product. And I give the highest mark to them who has give the good product. Yeah, so the highest mark to the student when they give me the good product, and then the product we give some assistance, yeah, to them and develop to go to the next level. This is some student. Yeah, this is some student. They won many competition, yeah, a student competition, local competition, national competition, and also international competition. This is one of the pilot project, yeah. You know, I said that we train the students, yeah. In 2016, we train the student how to develop the product, something like this, yeah. And then, you know, in 2019, their business has transformed to PT. Yeah, so start from business in the lecture class, but now they have company. Yeah, they have company, they call PT Aceh Kutaraja Aromatik. Yeah, and then now this is the director of PT Aceh Kutaraja Aromatik. Now this company, one of the company who buy the what we call royalty, yeah, the royalty of a research product of the Syekh Kuala University. So they buy the royalty of the perfume and they develop their products, their own product, and they sell everywhere. Yeah. So this is just one example that our class can be transformed into the business entity. Yeah. This is many activity, dear activity of PT Aceh Kutaraja Aromatik. They have product. You can type in the Google. You search in the Google. You type Ramu Official. Ramu Official. You can find many product of Ramu Official. That is come from our class in Syekh Kuala University. We also develop training for the community. Yeah, this is not student, but this is the people, the young people of the community. Yeah, you know, we do expertise we do advertise in a newspaper. Yeah, we look for 20 people to train them. Yeah, you know how much people that register to our project? It's 5,100 people. They register to our training, but we only can catch them at 20. So you can see, yeah, a lot of young people actually really, really needs to develop their skill, to develop their entrepreneurship, yeah. But we have the limit money, yeah, to train them. So this is a very good program actually. This is my friend, yeah, from I think Untirta, and also this is from Untirta, Dr. Indar, Dr. Entarto. They give some testimony in the social media. They mention that our perfume is very, very good quality, similar to from France, yeah, the perfume from France. Our perfume, he said that fresh, soft, and long lasting. And also my friend Dr. Indar spray the perfume to their scarf, yeah, her scarf, and 5 days after he spray the perfume, the smell still there, yeah. So it's very, very long lasting perfume. And in 2020, we developed the cooperative, yeah, because our business should be organized, should be run professionally, yeah. Because we are research center, we are a lecturer, we have the limitation ability to do the business, but then we develop the young people, yeah. We develop what we call Koperasi Inovasi Nilam Aceh. And in only in 1 year, they have omset almost more than 2 billion rupiah, yeah, in 1 year. So this is very, very good business actually, if we can develop based on essential oil. This is our production house in ARC, yeah. And you'll see this is also, we sell the product in mall, yeah, in Banda Aceh. And also we sell online. And also this year in 2020, we established the PT Ugreen Aromatik International. This is the joint venture between Koperasi Inopak and Nut Green France. So we have a company with France with the share investment of 60% for Inopak and 40% for France. This is the director of the PT Ugreen Aromatik International. Yeah, in 2020, August 24, 2020, our rector, yeah, also the launching new product. Yeah, this is the body butter. This is the new perfume, new variant of perfume based on patchouli and traditional flower of Aceh. We call bungong jumpa. Yeah, bungong jumpa. Yeah, so we put essential oil of bungong jumpa here, we put patchouli here, and then we can sell the product. Yeah, this is a very, very good product. And we also have Alkina product. This is the body butter, hand sanitizer, soap, and many others product. This is our agreement with France, yeah, Payan Betran, Prancis, yeah, Payan Betran, France. And also this is Nut Green from France also. We have agreement with them. We do business with them. And also this is from PT Haldin from Jakarta. You know, PT Haldin is one of the biggest extraction company in the world. Yeah, they have 6 plantation in Indonesia, the big plantation in Indonesia. So we have agreement with them, yeah, to develop the patchouli industry in Aceh. We have agreement with Central Bank of Indonesia. We have agreement with the Institute Atsiri Brawijaya University in Malang. And also now ARC become one of the destination of the visiting professor from outside, yeah, from abroad. Yeah. This is from Australia, Professor Moses, yeah, former deputy pro-vice counselor from Curtin University. This is from Germany. This is from Japan. This is from German. This is from France. Yeah. This is from UK and many others. Professor come to our research center and do some collaboration. We got some award, yeah. In 2017, we got Madani Award. We got Gemilang Award in 2018. We got Innovation Award from Gerti University. And also we got Nilam Heritage Award in 2019, yeah. We have agreement with the PT Haldin. We signed the agreement in front of the Ministry of Ristek, yeah. Pak Profesor Bambang in Jakarta. And also I was invited in 2018 by the former ministry, Pak Natsir. I speak in front of 34 province in Indonesia because they said what we have done in Aceh with patchouli industry should be replicated to other part of Indonesia with other essential oil product. We speak in keynote speaker in many conference. Yeah, I talk also with governor. This is governor of Aceh. How to develop our product in Aceh and how to increase the prosperity of our farmer in Aceh. We also has been invited to Korea. Yeah, I speak in Korea, Seoul in 2019, November. I speak about what we have done in Aceh. And also in 28 February of 2020, the Minister of Research and Technology also come again to Banda Aceh to launch officially our plantation of the refinery unit of fractionation of patchouli. Yeah, this is the army, yeah, the chief of Aceh Army, yeah, Pangdam, also come to our research center. They interested to help the people to develop the patchouli in other part of Aceh. And also, you know, this is the head of the chairman of DPR, yeah. DPR is Ketua DPR, yeah. Come to our research center, and also the Parliament of Aceh support our program to develop the prosperity of Aceh people. This is the conclusion of my presentation actually, yeah. Start from the raw material. This is raw material, yeah. This is the patchouli plant until the consumer, yeah, until the consumer. This is the value chains and supply chains of the industry of the patchouli. You can see here the blue color of letter here. The blue color, this is the program that has been done by our research center. Yeah, actually, in the last 4 years, we have done a lot to help the people to develop the process, to increase the market, yeah, and many others program to develop people with a knowledge-based innovation. Knowledge-based innovation, very, very important to develop the product based on essential oil. Yeah, this is our news in Australia about our program. This is a national newspaper. Yeah. Okay. This is the end slide of me. I think I give back to Ibu Tuzi, my friend.
Okay, thank you very much, Dr. Syaifullah. Wow, it's so interesting, isn't it? Well, yeah, it's beyond our expectation that previously we have a session about essential oil regarding the in terms of sources and its productions in laboratory scale. Now, we invite Dr. Shaiful to tell us more about the production in industrial scale, but then we also learn more about the flow of the research become business and how the pentahelix have been done by you and your team. Good luck. It's a great job.
Thank you.
It's really interesting, yeah. Dr. Fitri, yeah. All right. Dear participants, if you have some questions, you can write in the chat rooms. And then we have we have some a statement from Nathaniel Woon. Excellent presentation, Pak Saifullah. I didn't know the scene of patchouli oil was so long lasting. So yeah, very informative and comprehensive explanation of how patchouli oil can be produced and developed into a successful business benefiting the community. Yeah, the implementation of pentahelix is so wonderful. So yeah, is there any question, participants? If not, I have some questions here sent to me directly. Oh yeah, hang on. Yeah, the first question is sorry. Yeah, the first question is about in some innovation, how is the rule of patchouli oil? Is that just give the aroma or involve the chemical reactions such as in soap making? Or as you mentioned before that the patchouli oil produce the specific alcohol, yeah. So what is this, the constituent of that patchouli oil actually? The component, the main component.
Yeah. Actually, in the patchouli natural patchouli oil, when we finish the process from the leaf until the raw patchouli, it's contain around 35 to 40 component.
Yeah, okay.
35 to 45 component. We got this one based on the gas chromatography mass spectroscopy analysis. Yeah,
okay.
We can that component. But the highest component of the patchouli is patchouli alcohol. Yeah, patchouli alcohol. Patchouli alcohol actually in the perfume it will function as fixative. Yeah. The first function of patchouli in the fragrance is a fixative function. Fixative is the chemical compound that actually can hold the other components, the volatile components, to become evaporates. Yeah. Why? Because the patchouli alcohol has the what we call evaporates point. Titik uap apa ya?
Evaporate point.
Evaporate point. Yeah. It's around 255 degrees Celsius.
Oh.
Yes. Yeah. Patchouli alcohol will be evaporates when the temperature reach 255 degrees Celsius. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's very very high evaporate point actually for organic compound.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's why. Yeah. When patchouli alcohol interact with other compound, volatile compound, it will some chemical interaction between them. Yeah, actually not chemical process actually, but some like a physical bonding. Yeah, jadi dia mengikat ya, he has bonding with other component So it prohibits the volatile, others volatile component to evaporate. Actually,
just trap. Okay.
Yes, something like trap. Yeah, something like trap in the hand of the patchouli alcohol structure. But in the process, it will be evaporate actually, but not slowly. Yeah, evaporate slowly. Yeah, slowly, slowly, slowly. That's why the smell will be long lasting.
Okay.
Yeah, this is the first function of patchouli alcohol among others volatile compound. Yeah, in the perfume. That's why in the perfume at least we have three key component. We call base note, and then the second one is the middle note, and the top one is the top note. Yeah, the third one is top note. What is top note, the middle note, and the base note? The top note is the component, the chemical component that the first evaporates at the first time. It means it has lower evaporate point. It should become more easier to evaporate. So when we develop the formula of the perfume, we have to choose many essential oil that has different evaporate point. It's the secret of the perfume for long lasting perfume. So you know the patchouli will be stand for base note. Yeah, it's very very the last thing that can be evaporate from the perfume. Yeah, that is why many industrial perfume in France, United States, UK and Australia and many others use the patchouli. But they didn't buy patchouli from Aceh. They buy patchouli from Singapore. They buy patchouli from France. Yeah, France from Singapore. Singapore from Medan. Medan from Aceh. So it very very high change. Yeah, long change. That's why, yeah, the community doesn't got a the good benefit, price. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, so, this is the first function. The second function of the patchouli, the second function of the patchouli, it compose unique smell. If you smell the patchouli itself, I guarantee you don't like it.
Oh,
yeah, yes. If you smell the patchouli itself, you don't like it. It will be different if you smell bungong jempa. It's really, really wonderful smell. If you smell the rose oil or kananga oil, we will be like the smell because it's very, very nice smell. But the patchouli, not many people like the original patchouli smell. But when many other component, essential oil, and then we put the patchouli there, it will be composed the unique smell. That's why you know why, for example, I said to you, why Chanel, you know Chanel, right? Chanel is the one of the best fragrance perfume in the world. Yeah, they put patchouli inside. And until today, in 2020, they always buy the patchouli from Aceh. Why? Because they can't change the smell that has been received, accepted by the people around the world. They can't change the smell. And inside the smell, it contain the patchouli. That's why until today, Chanel come to us and also buy the Aceh patchouli. Because their product has been accepted international market, and they can't change the smell that has been good market, good level of the market. So the first one is fixative function, and the second one also compose the unique smell of the perfume. And other function of the patchouli, because it also contain caryophyllene, for example. Caryophyllene is one of the antibacterial component, and many others component, I think. Yeah, okay. Silakan Bu Tuzi.
Yeah, thank you. Regarding with the last function, there's also a question from Ibu Galuh here. Actually, plants has been reported to have antibacterial, antifungal, and anti-inflammatory activities. What component is responsible for these properties from those 40 components of patchouli oil, I think, yeah? Will the perfume making process decrease these properties of or enhance it?
Okay. So in my slide, I mentioned that we process further the raw oil of patchouli, yeah, with the machine we call rotary vacuum evaporator, and the second machine is WFF, yeah. WFF stand for wide film fractionation, yeah, the big machine. So what we have done with this machine, yeah, we divide the patchouli oil into groups, yeah. First group we call light fraction of the patchouli, and the second group is heavy fraction of the patchouli. In light fraction of patchouli, it's contain very, very low of patchouli alcohol, yeah, but high caryophyllene, high terpenoid compound of the patchouli. Yeah, it's a lot of fraksiringan, yeah, light fraction, fraksiringan dari patchouli. It's contain also for antibacterial and anti-jamur, yeah, anti-fungus, yeah. So with this light fraction of patchouli, then we develop the hand sanitizer. It has been tested in our test in our laboratory. Yeah, it can be work for the normal bacterial in our hand. So it's very good. Yeah, actually, it's contain very low level of patchouli alcohol. But in the second group of the patchouli alcohol, it's contain around 60 until 70 of patchouli alcohol. This product, yeah, this intermediate product we use for the perfume. So for antibacterial, actually we process and then they go around, evaporate first, and then we use for hand sanitizer. But the mother liquor we use as the a component for the perfume. So if we ask whether raw material, then the process, what about the caryophyllene, alpha-pinene, and antibacterial compound? It has been all go to the light fraction. Yeah, because we heat them above their evaporate point. So every light fraction will be go first, and then we use them as the what we call hand sanitizer and many others product. And the heavy fraction we use for component. Jadi ya nggak puas saya nih bilangnya ya. Jadi itu apa namanya senyawa-senyawa anti kuman itu kami gunakan di fraksiringan.
Yang berasal itu, dari fraksiringan.
Dari fraksiringan. Jadi itu sudah menguap pada pemanasan pertama. Yang pemanasan kedua itu fraksi berat. Sebenarnya ya banyak riset menunjukkan bahwa patchouli alkohol juga anti kuman. Tapi secara bisnis rugi kami kalau anti kumannya kami berikan juga untuk ke light fraction patchouli. Oh, okay. Karena Bu ya, patchouli alkohol yang 60% itu kami jual 6 juta per kilo. Per mili 6.000. Jadi yang untuk fraksi ringan bisa kita produce yang untuk produk-produk lain. Mungkin bisa ditangkap ya. Nah, sorry ya, ini tambah bahasa Indonesia lagi.
All right. So the components that use to make like antibacterial or hand sanitizer, they use the light fraction. Yeah. While the heavy fractions we use to other function, yeah, such as perfume. The reason is why? Because the price of the light part, the light fraction is is much higher than the light fraction. So if you want to use it as a hand sanitizer, can we use the heavy fraction for the hand sanitizer? Yes, we do, but the hand sanitizer will be more expensive.
Yes. So, exactly.
I think that's the point. Yeah. Pak Saiful, we also have question from Fatin. Which part of plant that used to produce the patchouli oil?
Sorry, can you?
Which part of plant
okay,
that used to produce the patchouli oil? Is it the leaf or the?
Yes. This is the leaf and the apa stem ya?
Stem.
Leaf and stem. In leaf, inside the leaf, it's contain 5% of patchouli oil. Yeah, and in the stem, it's contain only 0.3 until 0.5 of patchouli oil. But in the stem, it's a high content of patchouli alcohol. Okay, I repeat. In the leaf, it's contain 5% of patchouli oil. In the stem, only contain 0.3 to 0.5 of patchouli oil, but in the stem, high content of patchouli alcohol. So when we do steam distillation to the plant, we put 70% of the leaf and 30% of the stem. Yeah, because we need the higher yield of the production. And also we need the higher patchouli alcohol content. Yeah.
Interesting. So the stem will produce more of high fraction. Higher fraction. Oh yeah. Now is the question from Nathaniel Woon. I may have missed this, but I'm wondering how patchouli oil was traditionally used in Aceh. Are there traditional products made from patchouli that are still being produced and used in Aceh?
Okay. In Aceh? The patchouli plant itself, you know, in the world, there are three species of patchouli. The first one we call Nilam Aceh or Aceh patchouli. This is the species come from the Pogos Temon Kablin Band. The second patchouli is we call Nilam Jawa. Java patchouli. It's come from the species of Pogos Temon Hainanus Band. Pogos Temon Kablin Band, Pogos Temon Hainanus Band. And the third one is Nilam Sabut, the soft patchouli. It's the forest patchouli actually. So if we need to take the oil, it should be come from the Aceh patchouli, because the higher oil it's come from the Aceh patchouli. Pogos Temon Kablin Band is the highest content of the oil, of patchouli oil. And then, traditionally, some people use forest patchouli or Nilam Sabun. So why we call soap patchouli? Because the leaf can be used to clean the dirt. Use patchouli. It can be something like that. It's traditionally used. And also for the Aceh patchouli, it's come from Pogos Temon Kablin Band species. It's only used for take the oil. And traditionally, they use the traditional machine, and they sell the oil to the middleman, and then the middleman send to the exporter, and then the exporter send to the abroad, to Singapore, brand, and many others. So that is the only one the people in Aceh use the patchouli. That's why with innovation, we can use two others. Now our research center trains the people to develop many products based on the patchouli. Why in the past they can't use the patchouli? Because when the patchouli distilled traditionally, refinery traditionally, it will produce the oil with many impurities. The people use the river water to distillate the process. In the river, it's contain a lot of iron. yeah, besi, yeah, iron content, and in it will put in the process. So traditional oil will contain the iron. That's why we can't use to the skin. It can be dangerous, yeah. And in the during the years, yeah, many years, nothing to do with the patchouli. Just distillate with water river, send to the middleman, send to export, and then send to abroad. Only that, yeah. Okay. Hundreds years like that until our research center established in Aceh. Now we develop new approach to the community.
Yeah, excellent. Yeah, it's so interesting. And we also have one question from Farah Aziza Hanan. Is there any function or benefit we can take from the roots of patchouli? Because what we used to do is with the leaf and also the stem. What about the roots of patchouli?
Yes. I will be honest, yeah. We didn't do the research with the root, yeah. Yeah. So I think based on our question, after this seminar, I will contact my friend, Professor Rina. I will ask her do the research with the root of the patchouli.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for such homework for the
yes.
for Dr. Smith.
Thank you. No, Farah, yeah. Farah, thank you, Farah. Yeah.
Yeah, there are some more questions from the committee. One question is about this. What is the special physical properties that should be considered when we want to make an innovation product from patchouli oil?
Okay, color. Color, physical property, ya, yeah? Physical property one, ya. Color. So if we look at the patchouli oil, yeah, if the color is not clear, actually can be yellow color, but not clear. Buram apa buram ya?
Apa ya?
Yeah, apa not clear. Lebih mudah not clear. Yeah? Not clear. So for example, this is the oil. I put my hand here. Yeah, I put my hand here and I can't see my finger. Yeah. That means this is not clear.
Not transparent.
It means more impurities in the oil. Yeah. And if the oil contain the iron, it will be dark color. Like dark brown color, it can be replied that the oil contain the heavy metals, yeah, such as iron. That's we can't use this one to derivative products, so we need process more. Yeah, we can develop the process, a simple process to evaporate water, yeah, water inside, and also we can use vacuum distillation to divide it between the oil and the impurities. So asam lemak apa ya, fatty acid, the free fatty acid inside the patchouli oil will be stand in the residue. Residue when we evaporate the oil, yeah, it will evaporate all of the fraction, but it will stand the residue in the bottom, yeah. Its residue contain the impurities, fatty acid, iron, and many others. So don't use the patchouli directly from the refinery, traditional refinery, to the skin. But we can use it for the floor, yeah. We can use for the toiletries product, like the chemical liquid for the toilet, chemical liquid for the floor. We can use it. And also we can use it for the aromatherapy candle, you know, aromatherapy candle. You can use it, but we can't use it for the skin. It can be dangerous.
Okay.
So this is one of the physical property, but we still have others. Yeah, we still have others. I suggest you to find out with the SNI standard of the patchouli. We can get it from the Google. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Thank you for your explanation, Dr. Saiful. Bu Fitri, as a moderator, can I have a question?
Pretty sure.
Okay.
Please, very welcome.
I just wondering that in your presentation, you've mentioned that the historical Nilam, the historical found of Nilam. I just wondering how did Dutch do with that plant, with the Nilam, so that they know it is very beneficial, so that they export, and then they, that's what they did with Aceh. So how can they found the benefit of Nilam at that time?
Okay. I just know a little bit, So in the past, in the colonial era, one day, once upon the time, you know that the Dutch need really, really much money to finding their wall, and then they establish, VOC. VOC, VOC, one of their business is to find out what kind of the natural resources around the world. And then they take it and they trade it, They trade, they sell everything. Sometimes they process it and many things. So in the Dutch colonial era, VOC is one of the powerful body that has a lot of money and also a lot of assigned scientists there. They do collaboration with many scientists and then etc. That's why in Aceh, one of the main resources to get the money to funding their war is sugar, gula. So at that time, the world price of sugar decreased significantly. Jadi krisis gula di dunia. So the Dutch is very difficult to funding their war. Because the price of the sugar around the world has been decreased significantly. So no price for the sugar anymore. No price for the sugar anymore. In Aceh, they have a plantation of the sugar. Di Kabupaten Aceh Utara, Chot Gire, the Chot Gire village, until today we can find the plantation from the Dutch for the sugar plantation. And then, they try to find another commodity. They try to find another commodity. I don't know exactly how the process to find the commodity, but I know from the history that they find two commodity. The first commodity is patchouli. The second one is coffee. Coffee. They take patchouli from Philippines. They take patchouli from Philippines with the species of Pogos Temon Kablin Band. They send it to Pasaman Barat in Sumatera Barat, West Sumatera. From Pasaman, it's come to the Sidikalang in North Sumatera, Sumatera Utara, and then from Sidikalang sent to Aceh. At that time, around Indonesia, around part of Indonesia, the best patchouli result is come from Aceh. And then after that, another company, not VOC, another company of the Dutch, they saw the VOC got a lot of money from the patchouli. Then they would like to plant another patchouli in Java. But at that time, the company of the Nilam, Netherlands in this Lenbo Maskapit, or Netherlands in this Lenbo Aceh Maskapit, prohibit another company to plant the Pogos Temon Kablin Band. So another company of the Dutch then try to find out another type, another species of the patchouli. They found it from the India. From India, they take the patchouli with a species of Pogostemon hainanus band, not kablin band, but Pogostemon hainanus band. They plant it in East Java, West Java, center of Java, yeah, and grow very well, very good growing. But when they harvesting it and they distill it in the Singapore, they didn't get the oil because the oil very low in that kind, in that type of the patchouli. Jadi bangkrut perusahaan itu, ya. Ya, bangkrut perusahaan itu sejak saat itu, ya. Since that time, only the Pogostemon kablin band has been developed to industrial process of the patchouli. So this is one of the history that I can find from the some literature. But actually, the process how they find the patchouli, I don't know.
But another homework then.
Another homework. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. But no wonder because VOC has lots of many funding for the scientists. Yeah. At that time. Okay. Such an informative session today. So happy that the pentahelix system were done from different stakeholders for this sector to work. Whoa. Well done, said Atika from UPM. But
UPM Malaysia, ya?
The participants of this session are from
Malaysia,
many countries, Malaysia, Philippines, Vietnam. We have also from Vietnam.
I just need to say that UPM from Malaysia, University from Malaysia, UPM has been come to our research center. Yeah.
Yeah, they had come to Attica. Your university also had come to UNSIA. Okay. Yeah. Now another question from Fatin Fakiha. I just wonder about the patchouli plant look like, and I search on internet. Its look has flowers. Does the flower have good smell, and why it not used for oils?
No, there is another type of patchouli. That's why I mentioned. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Some patchouli has the flower, but Pogostemon kablin bands, which contain a lot of patchouli oil, has not the flower. Yeah. I will show you. Hang on. Okay. Okay, this is the patchouli leaf.
Yeah,
this is the patchouli leaf. Yeah, mm-hmm. I take it from in front of my house. Yeah, so I plant the patchouli in front of my house in the pot. Yeah. So this is the Pogostemon kablin bands. Mm. This is the species, but the species has 5 varieties. Punya 5 varietas, ya. The first variety is we call varietas Lok Semawe, varietas Tapak Tuan, varietas Sidikalang, varietas Pacolina 1, and varietas Pacolina 2. So this 4 type of patchouli is come from the species of Pogostemon kablin bands. So the leaf something like this.
Okay. Yeah. Another question, Pak. I don't think the question will be stopped until the end of the session. What about the biggest challenge for you in handling the patchouli?
If you would like to know the challenge, the problem, I think you need to come to my office. Jadi. So what I has been present to you, that is all a nice one. Yeah, if everybody will give a very nice smile when they watch my presentation. But if I give you the real story inside, yeah, a lot of blood there. A lot of teeth drop. Yeah. So it is. This is really not easy. This is very hard. You know. Even you know, I mentioned that how to collaborate with the government, the private sector, the media, the university, the community. It's not really hard. Not easy. Even in our university, you know, even in one university, it's very hard to communicate each other, to get the good building of the team. It's not easy. So usually, if someone asks me to know the insight, yeah, the teardrop process, I will tell you someday. Yeah, this is not easy. Yeah.
But is
we too? Can we can deal it, ya. Kita bisa menghadapinya. Saya ingin sampaikan, ini harus dalam bahasa Indonesia ya. Saya ingin sampaikan, kehidupan ini akan menjatuhkan kita di mana-mana. Kita akan jatuh air mata di mana-mana. Tapi pilihan untuk bangkit dari kejatuhan itu ada di tangan kita. The life will fall down us everywhere, but the choice to stand up from the down is in our hand. So kita yang putuskan, we make decision, ya. Jangan menyerah, never give up. If you see my motto,
status, yeah.
The status, always never give up. Because sudah berdarah-darah, Bu. Saya ingin cerita, ya. Saya ingin cerita. Saya minta maaf dulu kepada yang bahasa Inggris ya. Saya udah 5 tahun ini mendefinisikan diri saya sendiri dengan anak muda India. Jadi anak muda India itu, ya, anak muda India itu, kalau dia sudah cinta sama nona India, dia kejar bagaimanapun. Kalau dia dihalangi oleh bandit, dia hadapi bandit itu, dipukul-pukul, berdarah-berdarah dia. Ditangkap sama orang tua nona India, dikeroyok, masuk penjara, tapi keluar dari penjara, dia kejar lagi nona India itu. Kalau dipukuli rame-rame sampai tidak berdaya, jatuh segala macam, berdarah-darah, dia kemudian pegang tangannya ke meja, dan kemudian dia bernyanyi. Ya, setelah bernyanyi dia sehat kembali. Dan setelah dia sehat kembali dia kejar kembali nona India itu. Begitulah ya, tidak pernah menyerah. Jatuh memang iya, air mata memang iya, dan hal ini hanya bisa dengan satu hal, yaitu ketangguhan hati. Kita cantolkan niat kita ini untuk berbuat kebaikan untuk orang banyak, bahwa yang terbaik manusia itu yang paling bermanfaat untuk orang lain. Saya ini bersekolah di Australia menghabiskan uang negara 3 miliar. Dan itu adalah uang bapak-bapak, ibu-ibu, nyak-nyak miskin yang keluar dari rumah di subuh hari, jualan di pasar Aceh dari pagi sampai dengan malam, diambil pajaknya oleh pemerintah, masuk pajaknya ke kas daerah, disetor ke kas negara di Jakarta, menjadi skema negara untuk APBN misalnya, 20% untuk dana pendidikan, sekian persennya untuk kami bersekolah. Sekarang saya sudah jadi dokter, punya gaji, punya kehidupan. Tapi masyarakat kita masih miskin. Ini motivasi yang tidak tergantikan dengan uang. Nah, jadi ini dia ya, yang saya bilang never give up, persoalan banyak. Mungkin Ibu tolong jelaskan seperti yang saya jelaskan.
The conclusion life is really drama, ya. Yeah. Very touch.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for
good okay, yeah, 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 yeah. Time up. I think the other participants also have reached the points, yeah? Yeah. And really interesting. We are not only learn about patchouli oil. We are not only learn about the how you did the pentahelix in your work, but also the tough of yourself to face all of the challenge in front of you. Okay, yeah, Ezatul Sahira, you already got the personal invitation from Dr. Saifullah Muhammad to come to his office. Yeah, soon. Yeah. All right, Dr. Fitri, do we still have time for questions?
I guess we almost limited by the time. So since we still have one activity for assignment, for quiz. For other questions or inquiry regarding to the topic that just delivered by Dr. Saiful, the participant are also very welcome to keep the interaction through our Google Classroom. Later on, we will facilitate, yeah, for delivering your question to Dr. Saiful. Don't worry.
All right, thank you very much, Dr. Fitri, for the explanation. Yeah, Dr. Shaiful, thank you very much for such an inspirational stories, such an inspirational explanation and share to us, not only for the participants, but also for us as the committee, and also for our college, yeah, from our department who also joined these programs. And yeah, it's really interesting to be an Indian. Bufitri, maybe you can be an Indian woman. So if you both grow up and then you can just like singing and dancing.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. The motto, we have to remind the motto.
Yeah, after Indian. Crying, just dancing. That's the first point I got.
Singing.
Okay, just see at the bright side. That's probably the most common quote, yeah? All right. Yeah, so now we're going to move to another agenda. The quiz.
Yeah, only 4 minutes. So please kindly stay with us, Bapak Dr. Saiful, before we do closing session. So to all participants, again, we are kindly invite you to join with our assignment session. As usual, please join at www.kahoot.it with the game pick of today is 2001614. Yeah. Okay, please welcome. We are waiting for the participants to join. Don't forget the game point for today is 2001614. Okay. So far, 19 participants already joined with us. So the question will be all about patchouli for today. Yeah. Okay, thank you. So 25 participants enter to the Kahoot. 28. So we are waiting until 30 something for the participants. Okay. So now I will counting from 3, 2, 1, and the game is start.
Lagi.
If you follow the lecture from Dr. Saiful, I do believe you can answer this question. Yeah? So the first question is, Indonesia is the largest supplier of blah 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 essential oil. Okay, then we move to the next question. So Sinta, how to say, still temporary leading. For the second question is, the major content in the Nilam essential oil is, or in. Carefully. Wow, great, yeah, almost participant, yeah. Respond correct for this question. Oh, Aisa, come to the first. Now we move to the third question. Which one is not the problem of patchouli industry? Not that, around half can respond the question. Now Najiha, yeah, come to the first place for a moment. And then this is the fourth question. Which one is not the supporting system of a pentahelix approach to increase the patchouli productions? Which one is not the supporting system? Okay, Sinta now come to the first place for a moment. And then this is the two of last question. So the the part of patchouli oil that own the bacterial antibacterial properties is?
Hari ini hari apa nak? Rabu. Aduh, jam 2 presentasi ini.
Okay, done, and let's see who is the winner for today assignment. Atika in the third place, Sinta in the second place, and dancing, Indian dancing. Najmia, congratulations. Also, Faye and Mart as the runner-up, yeah, for today's quiz. Thank you so much for your great participation. We're still considering for the token, yeah, for today, for today's quiz.
Yeah,
okay, but Butusi, that's all for the quiz.
All right, thank you very much, Dr. Fitri, for the quiz. Dr. Shaifullah, I would invite you to provide the closing remarks, probably, before okay. We close the session.
Right. Okay, thank you. So for all students, this is time for us to learn more, to understanding about the knowledge, yeah, about the competency. However, don't forget that our knowledge, our science and technology should be used to our community. So don't forget it. You can be reach the highest level of scientists, the highest level of businessmen, for example, but don't forget to our community, because the good people is who give their expertise to others. That's it from me. Yeah. Terima yes. kasih banyak.
Okay, thank you very much, Dr. Saiful. So he remind us to dedicate our knowledge, yeah, for the community. All right, doctor. We also have something for you. Here it is. Since this virtual summer program, so the certificate also virtual.
Thank you.
Yeah, here it is for you from the committee of virtual summer school ethnochemistry in Indonesia Natural Department dedicate this certificate for you as our invited speakers. Yeah, I hope this is very interesting session, yeah, for today. Thank you very much, Pak Saiful. I think so. Is there any agenda for tomorrow?
Yes.
Tomorrow we're going to have a session about gentle introduction to jamu, Indonesian herbal drinks, and the speaker will be Dr. Sri Fatmawati, PhD from Institute Teknologi 10 November. So please stay tuned for tomorrow's session. And yeah, I think this is the end for today's session. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you very much for your kind of attentive and interesting questions and discussion. And yeah, nothing to say more. Just thank you very much to Dr. Saifullah Muhammad. Thank you.
See you later.
Yeah, see you later. Salam untuk Mbak Dede, Lukna Bulan, yeah. Dan satu lagi
sih. Ardan ya.
Ardan.
Ya. Makasih ya, saya pamit ya.
Iya, iya, makasih banyak, Dr.
Dr. Saifullah, terima kasih.
Belum difoto ya? Sudah difoto belum?
Oh, ya, yeah,
udah.
But still maybe some participant here if we would like to take the picture. So we kindly invite you, but as usual, most of them, how to say, turn off the video.
It's been left.
Everyone,
yeah, it's all right.
Okay.
just I think on at the mm-hmm. end of the session, okay. And the end of the mm-hmm. the last day of the virtual mm-hmm. summer program. Don't forget to take a picture. Mm-hmm. All right. Yeah.
Okay. Please don't forget to send your response on the list for all participants, yeah, to be recorded in document. So the link, attach people, and also we provide it in the chat room, just in case you miss the link for attendance list for today. Butusji, thank you so much for moderating the session. For today's session, it was great. Yeah, I almost crying as well. Yeah. Every time when I have a chance to have a great interactions with a great scientist like him, it's just like the, how to say, hair bomb. Yeah. Yeah, so yeah, very. I'm a kind of ion or even nanoparticle. That's incomparable. Yeah, with his great achievement. So yeah, okay. Really motivated for us. It's really inspiring for us. Hopefully, yeah, we can follow his great success story.
I mean,
all his sincere contribution to the community. Yeah, for to be a good man, a good, how to say, a good citizen. Yeah.
Yeah.
With the great contribution to society. So everyone, okay. Thank you. Stay healthy. Yeah. See you again tomorrow. We will move to Jamu topic for tomorrow. For the one who really love Jamu, don't miss it. Yeah. Tomorrow morning at the same channel, at the same time.
Okay, thank you very much everyone. Saya pamit ya Bu Fitri ya.
Ya, terima kasih Bu.
Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon everyone.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Yeah. Have a great day. Yeah, and thank you Bu Galu. Yeah. Thank you everyone.
Thank you everyone.
Thank you. Stay healthy.
Thank you, everyone.
Tomorrow. Thank you, Patin. Thank you. See you again tomorrow. Thank you so much. Don't forget, to fill the attendance list. And if you still have any inquiry, please don't hesitate to contact us, through the WhatsApp group. As well as through the Google Classroom, just in case you need. Thank you, Nguyen. Thank you for T-Camp Champion. Thank you so much for your great attendance. See you tomorrow. See you again tomorrow. Wish you a great day. Thank you so much. Okay, for the one who hasn't yet fulfilled the attendance list, please kindly complete it. And then, it would be a great help for us, to record your activity for today.